Engine call ready for deployment.
And welcome back. Well, stuttering in darkness. I'm the RPG chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda. The interesting thing I've found out. I never noticed this before. If you go in here, you could see not only the time played, but the completion. Supposedly, I'm 10% done with the game. I haven't hardly done anything. Or maybe 10% done with the main quest. So I'm not sure what the 10% is based on, if it's based on the main quest or, you know, the entire, you know, you've explored everything, you've gotten every achievement, you've done every quest, you've gone in every world, that kind of thing. I don't know. Anyway, we finish or continue looking around the Tempest. Is this something? We often run a little jerky when we start, but I'm not... It's not writing itself, at least not yet. Biolab. Let's take a look in the biolab.
That's the biolab. We can grow plants for food and oxygen, keep any specimen safe.
Oh, goody. Now, I do apologize, my voice is a little off. I don't know why. It's been a little off since yesterday, so... Is there anything to look at? Who is this a photo of? That almost looks like a Star Trek symbol on the side there. The insignia. Okay, if there's anything to select, I am not seeing it. Biolab, got it. Let's go back up to where we were. Yeah. Strike team missions, I didn't check that out. I guess that does nothing.
Hey.
Hey, hey. Oh, buy or sell kiosk. Alright, I'm not gonna buy anything. I'm not gonna look at anything right now. Just know that it's there. The research center we were messing around with last time. And the strike team missions. Okay, these are the Apex missions. Okay, people were telling me that this doesn't necessarily launch me into multiplayer. Hopefully it gives me, you know, time to do it. So, we have Apex missions and other missions. Alright, so let me try this. So clear an escape route. I'm just going to send a strike team there. Oh, it expires. Look at that. We have a countdown clock. This one expires in. Now I'm guessing this is in-game time, not real, like, you know, our world time. Evidently we can't do all of them. How about, well, the Apex missions seem the most important, right? So let's obtain the tech prototype. I don't know if we just have one team, assign a strike team. We've heard reports of a valuable new tech prototype in the area. Investigate the facility and obtain that prototype. Mission traits are remnant. Okay, that's that mysterious stuff that we can use to make things for ourselves. No room for error and enemies everywhere. Enemies everywhere! Anyone get that reference from the first game? 10 mission funds. It probably is a reference to the first game. So, we get a bronze item loot box and a research data loot box. I like the idea of that. Loot boxes. Nice. Okay, so select. Would you like to play this Apex mission in multiplayer or send a strike team? Okay, so it's sending a strike team. 70% chance of success. Hostage Rescue Specialist. Okay. So we only have one team. Whoops. That bumped us out. What? Come on back. Wait. Did I clear that out? 'Cause oh, it's in progress. All right. No? I guess the team was chosen. Alright. Now this expires in like 22 hours. Can we do this as well? Nope. 'Cause we need more strike teams. We'll find out at some point how to do that. So, tech lab is that way. Bio lab is that way. And can I move this? Oh, I can. Airlock. Escape pods. Bridge. I have to go through there to get to that. Go through this little thing. And then what's... engineering. Yeah, engineering. Tech lab, okay.
Our tech lab is an engineer's dream. It's perfect for any delicate technical work.
Now, I assume at some point I'll be able to use this stuff, and this isn't just for show, because this would be a lot just for us to walk around and say, oh, well, it looks nice, interesting, and stuff, and then never go in here again. Different worlds, nice. Well, that looks like the Citadel. Cool. Alright, tech lab.
Hey.
Is that all you say is hey? So what's this way? Engineering? Sort of. Go to the bridges. Oh. Wait. Engineering is back behind us. Okay. Alright, let's go there. Suvi!
We're almost out there. Finally.
It's very dark in here, Suvi.
Hello. I've just got to finish this download from the Nexus.
Oh, I love
that
accent.
Ready for launch.
I love that accent. Irish, I'm guessing? Maybe Scottish. She didn't say enough, so it's kind of hard to place. Oh, there's a ladder. And we've come full circle. Well, let's go... I remember that ladder's there. Oh, engineering. Why isn't she saying this is the engineering section? Or maybe it's not the engineering section. Cool.
Ryder.
That's me. I see you've got the sphere. It's not exactly a perfect featureless sphere, like in the movie, the sphere. Gil!
Ryder.
Gil?
Hi there. Can we talk and stuff later? I've got some last minute adjustments. She'll be ready to go when you are.
Doing some some calibrations? Ryder. Stop saying Ryder.
Hi, Ryder.
Hi. Okay, so there's a lift. Let's take the lift. Going down. Shuttle bay? Cora? Place is so dark. This image doesn't change. I like the pillow. It looks comfy. Oh my god. Somebody get the lights.
Confirming, Nexus. We're good to go. Finalizing orders, flight plan, command access. Ready when you are.
Okie dokie. I'm not ready yet. Vetra? She's awesome. I like her a lot.
Securing cargo, and checking everything made it on board. The bridge report's ready.
Okay. Not going there yet. Just looking around. Nothing else to look at? Interact with? There's that ladder, I'm guessing, brings us up to where we were. We go up ladders a little slower than Shepard. Yep, ladder. We'd still do the slide down though, I like that. Cool. Medbay. Is this glass? Yeah, it's glass. Okay. Alright, so medbay.
Most of the crew bunks in here. Cozy, huh? But your room's got more of a view.
The beds actually do look a little comfy, a little cramped, but... Bathroom! Oh, who's that down there? Cool. Looks like a drawing from Oliver, age 24. the bigger one. Crew info board. Anyone want to help me move a couch? Oh, cool. So it's like a bulletin board for the crew, right? Not right now, but I'll keep you on my list, especially if you're biotic and can drop the weight. Pay you back in beer or whatever else we find. Liam. Comments. Are you serious? Suvi. He says, I never joke about comfortable seating. Welcome to your new info board. Congratulations, Pathfinder Ryder, on successful installation of your info board version 3.4. You are now ready to keep yourself and your staff informed on the latest developments aboard the Tempest. Info board 6. Comments. Okay, I've set up everyone's user accounts. Have at it, Cora. I wish I could leave a comment. Okay. That'd be cool if we could just write whatever we want on the board. You know, not that anyone could react to it, just and then come back and see it's there, that crazy thing that we wrote. Well, this is a bathroom with other stuff. I can't flush the toilet though. Where is my interactivity? I like being able to activate the shower and the toilet. Well, the shower you could activate in the doctor, whatever his name's, quarters. Oh, that's our room? I'm gonna check, save the best for last. Kitchen. Where's my huevos rancheros? So, yeah. Regarding the Leviathan mission, had a, what do you call it? A shower you could use.
Hello, Ryder.
Hello, Lexi. I will talk to you in a second. Respec station. Data pad. Okay. Choosing to spend credits will refund Ryder's skills. Each successive use of the respec station will increase the cost. No. Alright, so that's all that is. Yeah. We can't see the skills currently in use. It just, like, undoes them, I guess. Cool skeletoni. Data pad. You've got this. You'll need an old man a few hundred years your junior to tell you you're ready for this. I'll do it anyway because I know it's true. You keep your rider safe and I'll do the same with mine, Harry. You're a wizard, Harry. Hello, Lexi. How are you today?
Excuse me. I need to make sure we have everyone's medical files from the Nexus. Come by after launch, and we can catch up properly.
Okie finokie. Hello, Ryder. They need to do a little ironing out with this game, I'd say. So what's ahead? Are we still heading towards the... Oh, headed towards my quarters, though. I never went in there. Can I go up these ladders, too? Okay, cool.
These are the Pathfinder's quarters. Your quarters. Sam's router is down there, too.
Well, that makes sense that it would be my quarters if it's the Pathfinder's quarters. Thank you for explaining that, though. Check the wardrobe screen in your quarters to change your casual outfit. Okay, cool. And we've got some displays that which we can't do anything with, and we got this. Huh. Customize colors. Jacket. Can't say I think much of that. I'm just gonna keep it the same the way it is. So outfit color 1, 2, 3. That's the white, obviously. This is that blue. Oh, this is that blue. Whoops. Hold on. I kind of like that. And what's this color? Oh, white for... Oh, it doesn't even show up. I see. Just changing the accents a little. Alright, what else? What else to do and see and stuff? I do have a good view. I want to see what the view will look like from space. Email terminal. Cool. Emails. Wouldn't be Mass Effect without emails. Special delivery cache. Oh, Sam. You are Sam.
Verifying my connection from Hyperion to the Tempest. The Nexus confirms we're free to depart.
Okay. That was an enlightening conversation. Some kind of emails I have. Interviews. To Ryder, from Carrie Tavessa. Hello, Pathfinder. I'm a freelance vidmaker and could really use your help with my latest project. It's going to be historic, I hope, just like your mission. Can we meet on the Nexus for a chat? I can explain better in person. Carrie Tavessa. Acknowledge. Okay. We can archive too. Okay. So it's more interviews, reporters, and such. Pretty cool. Special delivery. Ooh, rock and metal. Special delivery cache. What's that? Nomad paint job? Is that extra outfits? Humans early space flight. Okay. Maybe that, I guess that added to Codex. No, nothing really changed here. Wait! My colors got undone. What? You bloody bastards. Why did my colors get undone? This is the one that... How about some blue and that's that then? Did I not? Wait. What am I not doing right? It's still set to it. Can I see myself here? I never did look at myself to see what it looks like. I can't really... Yeah, that looks better. Looks like she got burned on the back, though. Alright. I'm not sure what that other stuff did, the paint job and stuff. Maybe I'll find out. Okay, so we are here. Music, wait. Music system. I missed a music system. We must have music system. Ah, cool. Now I wonder if we're gonna have any the classic tracks here. What else we have? Dr. Perceptron? Coma duster? Are these actual, you know, acts that made these? Wait, was that the end? Off. I like that. That's cool. Check out the lights. Get down. Get on down. Alright, what else we got? If we go up these ladders, where does it take us? Is this for the bridges? I still want to go to engineering. Go to the bridge. Liam, Gil. I guess I've been in engineering then, where Gil is, okay. She didn't announce, oh, you're in engineering. This is where, you know, engineering type stuff happens. Airlock. I want to check out the airlock. Escape pods. Oh, galaxy map. Can I fall down? No. I'd do it! I'd fall down! Well, that's to the... Oh, I gotta go back. Oh, never mind. I came from that way. It's just so I gotta check out the armory.
Departure trajectory locked, Nexus Control.
Oh, yeah.
Time for introductions.
Solarian pilot. I remember.
You must be Ryder, Kalojath. A pleasure to be here, and to meet you, of course.
Got some stride.
I'll be piloting the Tempest at your word. Quite the ship, but it'll take a Pathfinder's guidance to see us through Helios.
I wonder if we're going to be spending the entire game in this one Helios cluster, as opposed to, you know, the trilogy where you go to... I don't know, what there were 15 different clusters? That's a pure confident. I'll keep us out of trouble.
Plenty of dangers out there, but I'll do my best to avoid them.
That's reassuring. Wouldn't want to lose my finest work to that angry cloud. I was test pilot for the Tempest's early prototypes. I admit, I'm itching to see how she performs out here.
The lighting screws with the character models.
So, how do I...
The console syncs with your implant. Just swipe, touch a destination here, and the nav system calculates everything.
People.
Very efficient.
Here's people.
It was optimized for a Pathfinder.
Everything's secure, if you're ready.
Is anyone ready for something this big?
I'm not ready yet. I gotta go back to the Nexus and do a couple things. Crossing galaxies was big, too.
We signed on for the big stuff when we came to Andromeda.
All right. Excuse me. Excuse me.
Command access is transferring successfully.
Science and monitoring stations look fine. Lexi's reporting in.
Helm is green. Gil reports the drive core is online.
This is it, Ryder. The Tempest is yours. Unless you've got something to say for the log.
Captain's log. Stardate, 2419, something? 2319. We are the Nexus's last best hope for peace. No. Keep dreaming. Yeah, we're the Nexus's best hope. Yeah.
I never planned to be Pathfinder. I don't know what's out there. But we're the Milky Way's best and brightest. We can do this.
Nexus Control, this is the Tempest, ident 2527, prepping to depart.
We're leaving now? I gotta go back. You don't understand. I was forced into this cutscene and now we're leaving.
Departure vector verified, Tempest. Godspeed, Pathfinder.
I thought one of those was sous vide and the Solarian pilot, so I was like, wait, what? We're leaving them? But no, those are others.
To Eos, then. What would have been our Habitat 1? Two field outposts put an end to that idea.
Maybe we can turn things around. Callow, take us in.
We're really making decisions here. We haven't moved. Ooh. You are here. Can we zoom out? Well, I do the mouse wheel and this happens, so I'm guessing not. At least not that way. Hide UI. Well, okay, so I guess our entire time is spent in this cluster. I'm thinking. Pfeiffer system, yeah, which is where it's supposed to go. Ericsson, for no apparent reason. And, Eos. Better beginning. I'm supposed to go there, too. So if I go... Zoom in is... Oh! Should be mouse wheel. I can change that, but... What about zoom out? I want to zoom out, but I guess there's not much to see. There's no real reason to. T? I gotta hold it? Alright. Cool. Oh, I like that. So I can talk to these people and stuff. Callow.
Glad you stopped by. You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector?
No, please do.
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
It's exhilarating.
I could stand here and drink in that view all day.
When I was test piloting the ship back home, I often did. Of course, it took a whole team to build the Tempest. I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why did you?
What can I say? We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. Hmm. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
It's a big step for one ship.
I like the Tempest, but I'm not sure I'd travel between galaxies for her.
The unknown frontier had its charms, too. It's just strange not having the rest of the design team. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion and O'Connell arguing equations, tapping on the console. Three drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Huh.
Hmm? Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Solarian arc missing, you might not get many chances to compare.
Hmm. Any word on the Solarian arc?
Did you hear anything about the arc back on the Nexus?
Not a peep. Isn't that strange? You'd think there'd be something. Not that I dislike your company, but it's lonely without other Solarians.
No, I get it. Well, there is Tan.
Cheer up, Kello. We'll always have Director Tan.
That snide little bureaucrat? All the more reason to find the others.
Had a feeling you would
I
like
I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father. We built her for this. She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please, come by any time.
See if any more options.
What can I do for you?
Oh. Any stories about the Tempest?
If you helped to build the Tempest, you must know plenty about her.
Just about everything. By memory, it was quite the effort to get her working. The initiative needed absolutely up-to-date technology, which we all had to coordinate, and some of it was rather tricky to acquire.
Acquire?
Buy, legally, and above board, of course. Yes. Sadly,
sure.
The other Pathfinder vessels were lost when the Scourge hit the Nexus. The Tempest is truly unique.
Hmm. Tell me about Solarians.
You know, I haven't actually met many Solarians.
Careful. Depending who you ask, we're conniving spies, genius researchers, or meddling scientists. We have to pack a lot of living into 40-odd years. Everything gets accelerated. Lines blur. I just hope we don't repeat our old mistakes out here.
Well, that's actually not bad at all. When you think about what they say about the Quarians. Okay. Goodbye.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
Looking around. Oh, we got an email terminal here. Anything new? Nope. Suvi?
Ah, Pathfinder. It's so wonderful to meet you. I'm Dr. Suvi Anwar, assigned to act as liaison between your crew and the Nexus Science team.
Love her accent. Liaison? No. Welcome aboard.
Welcome to my team.
They're gonna go that way.
I look forward to working with you.
Likewise. I can't wait to get to work. There hasn't been much to do so far, unfortunately. I've studied all the planetary scans. I've even had some hands-on experience with Helios soil samples. If you want, I'll send you my analysis on the native bacteria and microfauna. 60 pages.
Whoa. That's long.
That's a lot of pages. About dirt.
Oh, you don't have to be kind. I know it's barely more than a summary.
What?
Anyway, I've waited months to get out there to see Helios. It's why I joined the initiative. The Milky Way was just a corner of a vast universe, a corner of a tiny corner. We're the ones who got to step out of that corner. It's incredible.
The first time I handled a Prothean artifact, I was hooked. It was so alien. I just knew. There's more out there, and I want to see all of it.
I totally know what you mean.
Her hair,
so
though.
Will you be joining us on missions?
Oh, that's funny. Me, out there, with the guns and the danger and everything.
Her hair, well, Suvi's hair, looks like a sketch. Like a sketch on paper. Don't you want to see it all?
But don't you want to experience everything firsthand? I know I'd want to.
Oh, absolutely. But I know my strengths. Trust me,
sheesh.
I'm far more useful to you in the laboratory. Anyway, I've just received some instructions from the science team, and I really should go over them. Later, then.
I mean, I'm on high settings, so maybe ultra fixes the hair? But still, it should look good on high. Anything else?
What's going on?
Tell me about the Scourge.
What do you know about the Scourge?
Scourge.
We established that it's artificial. Someone put it there. or they did something that caused its creation. We don't know why. That's still a mystery.
What's your experience in the Helios cluster?
How long have you been awake in Helios?
Not as long as some. Missed the entire mess of the uprising, thank heaven. I was defrosted to replace an exiled member of the team. Not that there was much science to do for the longest time.
So what did you do?
Helped wherever I could. Made plans for science we would eventually do. Spent some time on an investigation, figuring out how long the food would last if the worst happened. Who's essential, who's not. Who gets what? I don't want to do that again.
Yeah, it definitely sounds like a Scottish accent to me. Like, Engineer Connolly? O'Connor? I forgot his name. One of the two. Yeah, that's pretty awful.
I'm so sorry. I can't believe you had to do that. With no arcs, no pathfinders, we had to plan for the worst.
And I'm going to ask her about the science team on the Nexus.
I take it you work closely with the Nexus science team?
I tried to keep in contact with them. We discuss anything and everything we discover out here. After all, many brains are better than one, and Dr. Aridana is worth two or three at least.
Hmm.
I work best when I have other people to bounce ideas off of.
Okay, Andromeda scans?
I'm still fuzzy about how we managed to see Andromeda all the way from home.
It confused me too. I mean, the light lag would have made any data 2 million years out of date. So I asked Dr. Aridana, and she told me, well, it wasn't her tech that did it. It was the Geths.
You're kidding. Those killer robots we had in the Milky Way?
Killer robots?
Those exact ones. The Initiative obtained data from an array in deep space. A Geth construct. According to Aridana, the Geth rebuilt a mass relay and turned the approach corridor into an FTL sensor.
FTL sensor. So a faster-than-light telescope? They could survey Andromeda as it was?
Huh. Not exactly, but it cut down the lag by... enough. We don't know why the Geth were interested in observing beyond the galaxy, though. Maybe we'll never know.
Hmm. That's pretty interesting. I like that idea. I was hoping they would actually explain it to where it would make sense and not just technobabble. So yeah, well done. Faster than light, which is, you know, already explained in Mass Effect in general. And instead of traveling, we're seeing faster than light. Did Dad know? My dad know?
Did my dad know about this? Why didn't he tell me?
It's possible he didn't know. The Geth are isolationist and hostile. Using the info, even obtaining it in the first place, probably crossed a lot of boundaries.
Hmm. Now you gotta remember, they're working on old information. So this is, doesn't take actually any of Mass Effect 3 into effect where the Geth actually started, you know, helping us, depending on choices we made. Alright, well, we'll talk later.
I should get back to things. Sounds good?
Sounds good. Love it. Hmm. Oh, these are the pods? Am I in the escape pods? So I am. Cool. Loadout station. So this is the airlock armor locker. Change your loadout. Ah! This is what I was looking for. I want to make this the default weapon. Wait. Eight mods. Okay. Okay, so now this is unchecked good. Cool. So now I got these mods on the Matok. Excellent. Pistols. What do we like? I think we were keeping the charger. Yeah, just because more ammo and ammo clips. So I don't have any mods for pistols, apparently. Yeah, I'll need lead. Oh wait, I do. Pistol magazine. It's a little confusing the way things set up like that. Obviously this one. And this one. Well, that's empty now? What? I want an assault rifle and a pistol. Not the Avenger. Okay, now they're both now it's all there, okay. Weapon 1, weapon 2. Because I want a backup pistol in case I run out of ammo or who knows, and or the Matok is just too unwieldy. Yeah, in Mass Effect 3, I used it pretty much the entire game. Maybe I hit unequipped by mistake before, I don't know. I used it pretty much the entire game, but only against huge things like those mechs and the brutes and stuff. Is this a... no, it's not a ladder. Too bad there aren't items I can find here, stuff like that.
Spoken since orientation.
It's all been so hectic, but I'm sure things will quiet down soon. Can't be worse than the Nexus.
Yeah.
Hey, can you drop by the biolab?
Okay. So tune back for next time when we drop by more stations areas again. Because now they'll actually talk to us, have more than a line or two to say. And then I'm going to head back to the Nexus, because we have a few things to do. So I really want to take care of those things before we move, you know, beyond. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.